We talked about the codec being nothing more than a way to compress and decompress a sequence of images. Now, the way you compress and decompress could be adhering to different standards. These standards, they evolve over time. They get complex over time. But the principles are the same. Again, you're trying to find some spatial repetition from one frame to the other, and some temporal repetition so that you don't have to, you know, send every single image in a sequence. If you're trying to detect a motion, for example, you can search in a number of ways and then decide this object is moving in a certain direction. Well, the more you search, the more accurate you are. The more frames that you reference, the more accurate you are. So basically what changes from one codec to the other, from like, I'm talking about the, not, you know, all the compression theories, but at least in the compression standards that we understand today, whether it's an MPEG-2 compression standard or H.264 compression standard or H.265 or HEVC compression standard, they all rely on the same principles. Each one of them, though, increases the level of complexity of how you can estimate your motion, how can you estimate your spatial resolutions and information from there, right? So there is more to video compression, just the codec, in a sense that, okay, the codec evolves from one to the other by adding more complexity so that you can represent the same image with the same quality, meaning when I decompress that image, I get as close to the real raw data that came in. That's what I mean by, you know, a higher quality. So when you compress something at one megabit, for example, let's take even a file. If you compress a file to 1 megabit or 1 megabyte, you want to reproduce it, you want to have the exact same file. Well, that's with files. With video, it's a little bit different. You might compress it and then decompress it to see it. You might be losing some quality because of how much you try to compress it. So the idea from one codec to the other is, if I enhance the way I compress things, meaning I add more ways to estimate motion, I add more ways to, you know, understand the details in an image from a spatial point of view, then I can go and squeeze it a little bit more and be able to reproduce it for the naked eye at the same quality. So instead of sending an image at 5 megabit a second to give me a certain level of quality, I can send an image at 2 megabit a second from a bandwidth point of view to give me the same quality.